best lawsuit ever. There is a couple in New Jersey suing their landlord, claiming they rented a haunted house, and they say that they've got the video to prove it, but will it hold up in court? Here's ABC's John Mueller.
It's the house caught between two worlds, now caught in a lawsuit. Michelle Callen and Jose Chinchilla say their New Jersey rental house is haunted, and they're suing to get their money back, claiming paranormal beings are harassing them daily.
There were three taps on the TV, and that's the same night that I got tapped on my shoulder while I was in the bed three times.
They claim they recorded strange voices whispering, "Let it burn. You be the judge." Listen again.
When we were sitting down over here on the bed,
the sheets were being pulled out of my hand.
Flickering lights, clothes flying from closets. It sounds like a scene right out of the movie Poltergeist. They even hired a team of Ghostbusters to prove their poltergeist is real. The Shore Paranormal Research Society says they captured it on tape. Watch the bowling pin in the lower left corner mysteriously fall over without anybody touching it. Take a look again. They call this residual and paranormal activity.
They're experiencing what they're experiencing. I 110%, I believe exactly what they're saying.
And remember those flickering lights?
Get out of my house.
Check this out. As our cameras are rolling, watch this light in the upper right corner. Sure enough, it goes on and nobody seems to be near a switch. But the owner of the home, orthodontist Richard Lopez, isn't buying it. He's countersuing the couple, saying they're just trying to back out of the lease because they're short on cash. The couple says that just isn't true. Will the couple be able to escape their nightmare on Lowell Avenue? Well, that's up to the judge, who will hear this spooky case at the end of the month. For Good Morning America, John Mueller, ABC News, New York.
Any church that goes against the Bible is not of God. In fact, their judgment is worse than those who don't even believe in Jesus, because with their blasphemies, they still proclaim followers of Christ. Therefore, with no shame, they make Christianity and even Jesus look bad to others. Woe unto them that call evil good, and good evil, that put darkness for light, and light for darkness, that put bitter for sweet, and sweet for bitter, in Isaiah 5:20.
Hi, I'm Nigel, and Jesus Christ saved me from my sins. So one of the themes of this video is a warning, and the message is to be careful with what you open yourself up to, because you might just allow Satan to grab a foothold into your life, like how I did. Be not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion hath light with darkness? And what concord hath Christ with Belial? What part hath he that believeth with an infidel? And what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? For ye are the temple of the living God. As God hath said, I will dwell in them, and walk in them. And I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord. And touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and will be a father unto you. And ye shall be my sons and daughters, saith the Lord Almighty. In 1 Corinthians 6:14-18. The only exception where you're going into darkness is to spread the truth of Jesus Christ. Spread the light, so that they too might be saved. But don't go back into partaking in things that God has saved you from. Don't go back in the same crowd that God has saved you from. Because God says in the Bible that the dog goes back to his vomit. It says, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord. And he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. In Isaiah 55:6-9. Don't wait to find Jesus Christ, because later it might be too late. I waited a whole 21 years before I found out that this world is completely empty without Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. I didn't immediately understand the Bible when I first started to read it because of all the anti-Jesus biases that's been instilled into my mind since I was a kid. But my thoughts are lower than God's thoughts, and his thoughts are higher than mine. I found comfort in this verse. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord, and depart from evil. In Proverbs 3:5-7. And that's what this ex-atheist did. Now God's promises do come true. Jesus Christ himself said that Satan came to kill, steal, and destroy. Well, Jesus came to give us everlasting life, and it more abundantly. Thank God that I was saved right before this West is judged. We're living in the end times, where people are turning away from the truth and love of Jesus to turn to every other wind of doctrine, chasing after their own lusts. And Jesus Christ is coming soon to judge the nations. Our lives, just like Michael Jackson's, can end at any moment. We live, then we die. The same way you come into this world, the same way you leave, with nothing and absolutely nothing. So what was the point? We're always investing our lives in this materialistic vanity, these empty lusts, these artificial securities, these water buckets filled with all these holes in it. And we're constantly trying to fill it up, but it's never truly enough. They never truly satisfy. Only Jesus fulfills. Only Jesus completes. Are you comfortable with these demons as your master and Satan as your father? No sane individual would be. What's sitting on your shoulder, telling you the garbage and the lies of the world into your ear? What's keeping you a slave to sin and a bondage to Satan? What's keeping you away from Jesus Christ? Jesus yearns for you. God wants you to get to know him. God wants you to be a child of God. It's a choice at the end of the day. No one can force you. If you put your trust and faith in Jesus, you will be saved. Read the Bible. Repent. Believe. Call on his name, and you will be saved.